this next comic coming to the stage, he started stand up later in life, but is still very hip. He is the host of the Behind the Bits podcast. Funny, funny man. Please give it up for Mr. Scott Curtis.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, folks, I'm Scott Curtis, and I make some assumptions about what you're thinking when you see me. I know most of you are saying that boomer don't look very woke. I can assure you. I can assure you I am in fact woke. I actually got the woke boomer card, which gets me into independent coffee shops, comic book stores, and poetry slams all across the nation. I'm also positive you kids think I'm older than my actual age. The reason why is because just the other day I went into a Speedway gas station and I got a Diet Sunkissed orange because that's something I like to get for myself as a treat. And the cashier said, "Hey, you look like an older Harrison Ford." And it's amazing how many thoughts go through your head in the 3 seconds from the cashier to the door. First, Harrison Ford's pretty good looking. Thank you. Next, I think he's a little bit older than me. Next, he's 77 and I'm 56. So I called back over to the cashier. I said, "Young lady, did you mean younger Harrison Ford?" She said, "Nope." So I'm working on moisturizing. Now, aside from being woke, I'm pretty normal for a 56-year-old. I've been with my bae for 37 years. Thank you. And we're not just together, folks. We are in love AF. Always and forever.
Oh,
yeah.
Ain't that sweet? One of the things that keeps us together is we do a lot of stuff together. Before the whole COVID hit, we joined a gym. We joined the Planet Fitness. I'm sure you've heard of that. I did not know when I joined that it was going to be a gateway gym. I'm doing my thing on the elliptical like I always do. And this guy comes up to me and he says, "Hey, dude, you're enjoying those endorphins, aren't you?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Why don't you come over to my CrossFit gym and I'll give you 10 times those endorphins." So I took him up on his offer. Next week, I went in. Everybody was nice. They put me on a meal plan. They showed me how to flip the tire. Very next week, I am stealing copper out of construction sites and donating plasma just to keep my dues going. Because it's like drugs. Another thing we started this year so we could social distance is kayaking. We bought kayaks, and I love kayaking. The thing is I see other kayakers, and I think it's kind of like motorcycling, and I think there may be a sign because those motorcycle people are like, "Hey, you're riding a motorcycle? I'm riding a motorcycle. That's cool. Here's my hand." So I thought that maybe kayaking would have the same thing. So I started experimenting with my oar because that's all I have to work with. So I'd go past somebody and I'd do this. No reaction. So I did a double. Boom, boom. No reaction. So I did a double. Boom, boom. Twirled over my head. Slap it in the water. And still no reaction. So I gave up. And then I passed this dude and he said, "Hi." And I'm like, "Holy cow, there's no noise out here. We can actually talk. This is great." I said, "Hi." My boo and I have made a couple kids. They're adults now, and they are way more successful than me. So I've got a vice president of a multinational company and a rocket scientist. That's what I've got. Meanwhile, I'm just negotiating the cable bill. But people say, "Man, you must have raised them right." And I tell you what, I think back, and I'm pretty sure I didn't poison them. But one thing I did do is I did not tell them they could be anything they want to be. I told them what they couldn't be. There was a couple things that were on the top of my list. And the first one was a reality show contestant. You ain't doing that. If I see you on Big Brother, there's going to be big problems. And the other thing is a CrossFit instructor. see the Gateway Gym joke for that. We don't want you pushing that stuff. And the biggest thing is president. I don't want you guys running for president because they're going to dig up that stuff I did in 1982. So I started stand up at 52. I called my kids and I told them, and they're like, "Dad, that's fantastic. That's a great idea. Keep the brain working." And they hung up and called my shorty and said, "Hey, what's wrong with Dad? Time? Should we be coming home?" One of the things I deal with being with my boo as long as I've been is a lot of people like to throw shade at us. I call them haters. I don't know what you call them, but they like to say things like, "You've got nothing in common. How do you stay together?" And guess what? We got stuff in common. One thing is we don't like other people's kids. We raised our own. We don't want to babysit yours. They don't even look like us. Next thing, human trafficking. Yeah. We're both against it. Hey, yeah. Had you on your dates, didn't I? So I am so confident in the fact that we are against the human trafficking thing. If one of you sends me a private Zoom chat and says, "Hey, let's do this human trafficking stuff," I can say I don't have to ask my wife because I know it's a hard no from her and a hard no from me. It's both a hard no. We're not going to get into that. Nice. Also, the biggest thing about us is we don't front. My shorty and I don't front. She doesn't front. I don't front. No fronting. We don't know what it means, but I'm pretty sure we don't. Next, I got to tell you, I got a guy at work that's a bit of a playa, and that means he gets with a lot of different women. And he said, "How can you stand having sex with the same woman for 37 years?" And so I didn't even distinguish that with an answer, so I'll tell you since I don't know you. When you have sex with the same person for 37 years, you get good at it. You know where all the erogenous zones are. It's all muscle memory. It's easy. You don't have to say, "Did I do okay?" And next, you may think we don't try new stuff. Oh, golly, we try new stuff. The only thing is we're both a little broke down, so we put it up on the whiteboard. I'm like, "Honey, stay off that left knee. Watch my back. The safe word is still stop it." Thank you. I'm Scott Curtis. Thanks for having me, folks.